You guys have been asking for it, and I am happy to deliver. A little later than I'd hoped. I was all ready to react to this, and then I got COVID. Not much I could do about that. I was shot for like 10 days. This is now a bit old. In internet years, 10 days is ancient history. All the other reactors have beat me to the punch by a lot, but I don't care because you guys wanted it. You wanted me to react to New Ghost from the new album since it's been released, Impera. So I'm starting with Spillways because somebody said that was one of the better ones on here. So let's see what they got. They're doing the opposite of the sus resolve. It's the chord and then the sus. But through all this time, you try to peel it off, and it's such a ride. Your desolation led you into this final incarnation of consummated bliss. I know. Pedal tone action. Oh, key change. And again, two key changes right in a row. Chop a piece. Super Boston. Very, very Boston-esque. They're loving the and of four. You keep a casket. Where did we just go? Harmonically. I am pleasantly discombobulated. Like end of four, the musical. It's like pretty straightforward, like bulletproof four chord progressions, but moving them around to different keys. It is absolutely wild to me that this album with this much harmonic complexity is number two. With solos that ripping, I just talked over Frederick's solo, but they went more technical and shreddy. It's just a bop. It's just nice. I have no idea what a snow is. Oh, no idea. Hot damn. This is a really interesting technique. I do this to some extent pretty often. For example, like a real basic four chord progression and then a different one, but they're in different keys, like wildly different keys, or at the very least, it sounds like he's moving quite a bit. Once again, I'd have to spend a little more time with it, but like, whoa, woohoo! We are all over the map. Here's a super familiar sound, this real basic pop chord progression with a nice catchy melody. And that lives here in this key. And you could do the next one in the same key, keep it diatonic and kind of boring, or you could be crazy like the Papa and just put it in a different key just to make it exciting. Why not? Isn't that much, much more interesting to listen to? If you don't like this music at all, there's still tons that you can learn from this. tons and tons. That's how I want you to look at all of this stuff. Anything that I'm going to break down, that I'm going to react to, whatever. Don't worry about whether or not you like it. There's tons of stuff that I don't like at all that I learn a lot from. This is a cool song. Real poppy, real boop, boop, happy and kind of major key sounding. Some real wild shit in there. I am of the opinion that there is absolutely no reason that something can be both extremely simple and catchy and then also very harmonically rich and interesting with lots of cool, tasty surprises. It's an excellent combination of the familiar and the wild. It's very comfortable, but pushing the boundaries also quite a bit. Very straightforward song structure, very evocative of Hold the Line by Toto in a lot of ways, and then it goes way crazier places. Another ripping solo. I kind of talked through it. I'm gonna have to listen to it again, this time with wah. Been hearing a lot of talk like, oh, they're mellowing out, they're selling out, they've gone all soft and pop and whatever. Why are the solos longer, more involved, and more ripping, more shreddy? Wouldn't it go the other way? Wouldn't they cut out the guitar solos entirely if they were, like, selling out? Absolutely no reason on earth to hire a dick ripper.
What did he say?
Like Frederick from Opeth to rip a bunch of shreddy ass solos on your album if all you're trying to do is sell more albums. Like, guitar solos don't really sell albums outside of power metal. So that feels like, it feels like bullshit is what it is. In reality, they're taking much, much bigger risks and going way crazier than they ever have. I think the old stuff was definitely playing it safe. This is taking huge risks. Not in the song structure. The structure of the song is very straightforward. One of my jokes from the How Ghost Writes a Song video is the whole sus resolve thing. Here they're doing it backwards. It's the chord resolves going to a sus chord. Sus. So they took this same kind of arpeggiated chord idea, the same way that they were doing it, and then moved it through a couple different chords other than the ones that they had originally done. To get us to our new key. I've done this before. I'll write a song. I'll write two different parts for a song, and they work really well, but vocal melody doesn't really sit in my range very nicely. So I'll want to move one of the parts to a different key than it was written in, just so that I can sing it really powerfully with the same melody. And I have to do some really tricksy shit to connect the two things. So it's possible that he wrote this song, one of the parts in a different key, and in order for it to fit in his range, he had to do some wild shit to get to a different key. You gotta, like, move mountains sometimes to get to where you need to go. In this case, I think it made it really exciting and interesting to listen to, because we've gone very far from where we started. But yeah, those really awesome little harmonized guitar bits filling in the gaps in between stuff. That's very Boston. I hear so much Boston in Ghosts. Also sounds a little bit like Blind Guardian. And leaving it unresolved for Satan.
For Satan.
Hail Satan!
If nothing else, Tobias Forge has done his goddamn homework on classic rock. Okay, the dude knows his shit. This is full of the parts of classic rock that were awesome, and he yeeted the rest. This is straightforward pop style songwriting and structure, which he's openly admitted to loving and going for. Big harmonies from the 70s, the piano sounds, the harmonized leads, none of the bloat, none of the sort of proggy bloat Led Zeppelin experimentation or like Kansas. I love Kansas dearly. Okay, extremely underrated, super influential prog band, but they had these very long, proggy, extended songs. There's none of that. It's just straight to the point with extremely complex harmonic moves. Exciting, over the top, wild harmonic moves. It's not just constantly taking you wild, crazy places. It's like a crazy little trip to somewhere very familiar, catchy, fun. Another little like, and then land. Oh, but you're rewarded for the trip. Here's a super catchy four chord, happy little banger, and then a ripping guitar solo, and I'll see you later. Bob's your uncle. I hope there's more of this in the rest of the album, but I'm really enjoying the direction of this. Please let me know other things you want me to react to. If you want to learn more about writing songs, you're definitely going to want to check out my course. It's called Complete Rock and Metal Songwriting. There's a link in the description for that. And you're going to want to check out my most recent songwriting tutorial, which is right here. It's about how to get people to stop skipping your songs. That's really important. Ghost knows how to do this, so check it out, and I'll see you real soon.